Hello, we continue our series Verge3D for Maya Basics. In this part of the tutorial, we'll set up the materials and the environment for our scene. In the previous video, we copied all the textures from the starter files to the app folder, so now we'll be using them to create the materials. First of all, we have to set up the environment that will serve for lighting and reflections. We'll be using a SkyDome Light for that. It can be added through the Arnold menu by clicking on the corresponding button, Create SkyDome Light. Now we can assign an environment map to it. Go to SkyDome Light attributes and instead of color, assign file. Then select the HDR texture that we copied from the starter files. Now, if we enable lighting in the viewport, we can see that our model is lit by the environment map. Let's proceed with the materials. Go to Windows, Rendering Editors, and launch Hypershade. Let's make its window smaller a bit. Now let's create a new material. To do this, go to Arnold, Shader, Surface, and add an AR standard surface material. We'll be using this material for the body of a knife, which is made of plastic. So let's name it accordingly, plastic. Now let's open up the application folder to which we copied the textures and drag the images relevant to our material right to the Hypershade editor. So we've got here textures for roughness, base color, metalness, and lastly, normal map. So let's connect them one by one. The base color texture obviously goes to the base color input. The roughness texture is basically a black and white image, so we can only use one channel, for example, the red channel. Connect it to specular roughness. We should also switch color space for this texture to raw. The same we do with the metalness texture. Connect its red channel with the metalness input and switch color space to raw. Lastly, let's deal with the normal map. We also switch its color space to raw. However, to make it work, we'll need an additional node called Bump2D. We'll be using the alpha output rather than color as bump value. This looks counterintuitive, but this is how it works with Maya. In the Bump2D node, we should switch to tangent space normals. Finally, we should connect it to the normal camera input of a material node. Now the material is ready and we can assign it to the relevant model parts. In the outliner, select back cover and front cover meshes and assign to them the plastic material that we just created. Let's check it out in Maya viewport. Looks great. Now let's add the pre-baked ambient occlusion map to our material. Again, we can drag it from the app folder. Let's make some space for it. We should switch it to raw, as we did it for the other non-color textures. Once again, we have a black and white image, so we can use just one channel, e.g. the red one. Let's make some more space. So let's connect it to the base input of the material, as well as to the specular input. Now, in order for ambient occlusion to be correctly applied to metallic surfaces, we'll be using the following trick. Let's find and add another node called Float Composite. We'll use this node to handle the metalness properly. First of all, let's connect the red channel of a metalness texture with this node. In the input below goes the occlusion texture. And finally, the result of this mix-in goes to the metalness input of the material. In the node settings, be sure to switch the operation selected to multiply. Let's check it out in the viewport. We indeed have the occlusion map applied to our material. However, the occlusion is apparently out of order. The thing is that the knife model has two UV layers in it. One of them is used for the main material textures, while the other is intended for the pre-baked occlusion. The reason for having two UVs is that the occlusion is baked for multiple objects of the knife model, so its texture space is shared between these parts. Now let's fix this issue by assigning a right UV layer for the occlusion map. Let's get back to our nodes. Now let's temporarily connect the occlusion texture to specular color, for example. Then go to Windows, Relationship Editors, UV Linking, Texture Centric. In this editor, select Swiss Knife A01 on the left. This is how the ambient occlusion map is named. On the right, we should select the name of the UV layer, which should be used for this texture. The name is AO. As you can see, the occlusion is now correctly applied on one side of the knife. Let's do the same procedure for the other part, covered by the plastic material. Again, select the texture and then the UV. Now the ambient occlusion map is applied to the very same surfaces which is supposed to occlude. That's it. Let's disconnect the occlusion node from specular color that we used just for our convenience. After disconnecting, it is reset to black, so be sure to restore its original color. Now this material is ready. Let's proceed with the rest of the materials. Next materials we want to set up is chrome-plated steel for the blades and other instruments of the knife. Let's get back to Hypershade and add a new AR standard surface material. We name it Chrome. For cleaner workspace, let's make it the only visible material in the editor. This is a very simple material. We just move the metalness all the way up to 1 and make it a bit darker. Now let's assign it to all blades and instruments of our knife model. There are plenty of them. We do this by selecting all the relevant parts in the outliner. Now just assign the material to selection. Let's check in the viewport. It seems we didn't miss a thing, which is great. Okay, now let's add ambient occlusion to this material too. This will be the only texture in this material. Again, let's drag the occlusion texture from the application folder. Switch color space to raw and connect it to the base and specular inputs. You might remember that for a previous material, we mixed this texture with metalness. However, this case is simpler, since the metalness value is equal to 1, and as such, we can directly connect this texture to the metalness input. As a result, on the darker surfaces, the material will lose its metallic shine, just like it is observed in the real world. Now let's handle these plates between the instruments. To prevent scratches in the real knife, these plates are made from a softer metal, aluminium. Let's add a new material and rename it as aluminium. Make it the only visible material. This material will also have its metalness set to exactly 1. It will be lighter than chrome and its roughness will be higher. Now let's select everything made from aluminium. And assign this material to selection. Once again, let's add the ambient occlusion map using the same alt procedure. Everything looks fine. The only material left is plastic, from which this small handle and the toothpick are made. We already have one plastic material, so let's choose another name, simple plastic. As you may have noticed, we always give materials and objects meaningful names. By doing this, we make our life easier as we'll be accessing them later in the scenario editor. Make it a bit darker. And raise the roughness a bit. Maybe make it even darker. Now let's add the occlusion map. This time we'll connect it only to the base and specular inputs. This material is no metal and as such no need to engage the metalness inputs whatsoever. Let's assign this material to the small plastic parts. At this stage, we can export the scene. Go to Verge3D menu and click Export glTF. Select the All glTF file to overwrite. Open up the App Manager and run the application. The model looks great. All the materials are in place and nothing is missing. There is a small issue, however. If we look at the logo at oblique angle, we can notice some blurriness. Luckily, there is a way to avoid such a thing. Namely, we can enable the so-called anisotropic filtering for the textures. Let's get back to Maya Hypershade and select the plastic material. Now we'll be selecting the textures in this material one by one. And in Verge3D custom settings, we'll be switching anisotropic filtering to 16. Let's do it for all the textures in this material. Now let's export the scene again. Switch to the web browser and refresh the tab with our application. You can use Ctrl-R or F5 as shortcut. Now we can see that the texture quality noticeably improved. That's it with the materials. Thanks for watching and see you in the next part of the tutorial.